Hello and welcome in TeachMax videos. Let us move to the next examples on analysis of pre-stress members by using three concepts. Okay, so this is third example I am going to solve here. Okay, so go with this. Very simple. See the variety of examples here. Tendons, there are wires are provided instead of tendons, and they are 12 tendons of 5 mm diameter at bottom. It is provided in bottom zone actually, and it is at 65 mm from soffit, and four wires of 5 mm diameter, and it is provided at 25 mm from top. The size of cross section is 200 by 350. Okay, and the total pre-stress developed by these 16 wires, 12 plus 4, 16 wires are given, and it is 900 Newton per mm square. Span of the beam 6 meter subjected to live load 6 kilo Newton per meter is also given. The density of concrete is given, so it means self weight of the beam we need to calculate, because here live load directly given, so it is not inclusive the self weight. Okay, so that's why we need to calculate self weight separately. And what is asked? Calculate the extreme stresses develop at mid span. Stresses develop in the extreme fiber, top and bottom fiber, at mid span it is asked. Okay, so you can use any concept out of these three, because here concept is not given, not asked. Okay, so use this concept or this that one in example. So you can use any. So I'm going to use stress concept. It is very straightforward, very simple, that already we study in strength of material. So using this we can find out it easily. The job is to find out the pre-stressing force because of these wires and because of this pre-stress. Okay, so pre-stress is given, how much pre-stress is developed for this whole cross section. Okay, but and the number of wires and size of wire is given. So we need to find out pre-stressing force and its eccentricity. Once we know that, then you can solve it example easily. That's it. So the difficult task is to find out the pre-stressing force and its eccentricity. That's it. Once you know that, then you can easily solve these examples, right? So let us go with the first step. So first of all, we are going to find out sectional properties. Okay. So in this only you will get all these things. Okay, so area A is equal to 200 into 350. So 7070 into 10 raised to 3, you can say mm square. Okay, so 35 into 270, and there are 3 zeros, so 10 raised to 3. Okay, what about y max? Y bottom and y top are same, and it is 350 divided by 2, 175 mm. So it is given. Fine. Then moment of inertia will be, it is rectangular section, so BD cube by 12. So 200 into 350 cube by 12. So you'll get the answer. So 200 into 350 cube divided by 12, so it is 714.58 into 10 raised to, how much it is, 6, very simple, mm raised to 4. Can we find out z? Yes, z is equal to I by y bottom or y top, it is same, so z bottom, z top remains same, no change. Okay, so 714.58 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 175. So first of all find out these all, so answer divided by 175, so it is 4 point, just check it out, 71, yes, 4.08 into 10 raised to 6, correct, 4.08 into 10 raised to 6 mm cube. Okay, so we get these sectional properties. Also, we have to find out pre-stressing force and its eccentricity. Okay, so first of all, find out CG of these wires. So where these wires will concentrate, that CG we will calculate. So we know 12 wires are provided at 65 mm from soffit, and 4 wires are provided at 25 mm from top. So we have to find out CG of these 16 wires. So CG Y bar we can easily find out first of all, and it is 12 wires of 5 mm diameter. So this is the area of that wire, and it is from bottom, it is at 65 mm. So A into Y1, A1 into Y1 plus A2 into Y2. What is A2? A2 is 4 times pi by 4, 20 square, 5 square. This is the area of these 4 wires, and it is multiplied by distance from soffit. So what will be the total is 350. 350 minus 25, it will be this distance. So distance, see, we are finding Y bottom. So from bottom we have to take these Y1 and Y2. So 350 minus 25, it is 325. This total will be divided by 16 wires of 5 mm. So 16 times pi by 4, 5 square.